equipment that we need for this week's lab. Most of it came from under here, but I did grab the pulse transducer, which is right there, and the pulse transducer was right up in that area. So the other things that we're going to need are the actual AD Instruments box, and this is called a PowerLab. So we will need to hook up a power source to this. So there's our power cable, and then also a USB that's going to enable us to hook up to the computer. So I'm just going to show you where these things hook up. I'm going to bring this over to my computer and I'll give you a quick demo. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to hook up is my USB cable. And as you can see here, I have two options really to plug this in. This is going to be the computer side end, and then this box, this wire is going to go into the box. So I'm going to look at the back here, and right there I can see some place that looks like this will fit. It'll only go in one way, so I will just plug that in that way. And then I'll plug the other end, this end, right into the front of my computer. Then this power cable is going to plug into the back of the box as well. And there's only going to be one place that I can plug that in. And that's going to go right over here. And I just plug that in. And then, of course, plug it into my power strip on the table. And at that point, you can see that someone had left it on. So basically, the power and status is going to be blue and green. If you're not seeing that, there's something wrong with your setup or your power cable is not hooked up, something of the type. Then the last thing I'll hook up is this pulse transducer. And I'm just going to hook it up to input 1. So input 1 is right there. And that's plugged into input 1 securely. There's only one way it'll go in. There's a little arrow that'll face right up towards the top. So that's my setup. I'll be right back. Okay, once we have those three things hooked up to the PowerLab, what we're going to do is we're going to start up our software. So just the checklist again, we have the power cable. Then we also have this USB cable, which is going to hook into the computer and the peripheral. And then we also have this PowerLab pulse transducer, which is going to hook up to the peripheral as well as your human subject. So that's the setup. Once we do that, what we want to do is look on the screen here and we want to pick out the Lab Chart 7 application. So it looks like a little ECG. And once I've opened that up here, I'm going to get the choice for a lot of different settings files. And not only settings files, also different things. So we have an instructor guide, we have a laboratory report, we have sample data, also settings files which are going to run the software, and the student protocol for what we want you to complete during lab. So I'm going to click on settings files, and we're just going to use the BP settings for this. The instructions may have something different, and either one will work fine. They're really just the same settings files using this pulse transducer to get our data. So when I click on that, I get a little symbol that says blood flow, and right now if I click start, nothing is going to happen. And the reason is we don't have a human subject hooked up over here, so we need to fix that. Let me fix that, and I'll be right back. Okay, so now I've corrected our issue. Basically, I've hooked this pulse transducer up to my index finger. We want to use the index finger. That's probably likely the strongest pulse or pressure difference in the fingers. The thumb can be confusing because there's a larger artery in the thumb. So basically, let's just go with the index finger. That's probably going to work best for today. So I have this hooked up here. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to click start in just 1 second here. Okay, I'm going to click start now. And now I can see something is going on the screen here. And looks like quite a lot of fuzz, and we actually call that noise. It's likely that there's some kind of disturbance here. So what we can do is make a couple modifications. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into this area that says blood flow, click that, and then go into the input amplifier. So once I've done that, I want to look at some of the settings, and first I want to strengthen this to see what's happening. So I'm going to strengthen that signal, and then I'm also going to put a filter on this. So I'm going to put maybe a 10 hertz filter and click OK. And now let's see how this works. I'm just going to get my human subject to stop moving. And it does look like right now we've cleaned up the signal. And each of those bumps is just a pressure change in my finger due to heart rate. So what I'm actually seeing is how many beats are occurring in a given period of time. So it's really clean, and I have this hooked up to me, so you can see that there's a little bit more of a disturbance when I'm talking than not, so you do want your subject to be quiet. Now, you can make some other adjustments in that input amplifier to help you get a cleaner signal, and I encourage you to play around with that until you have a nice clean one where you can actually read the different counts. And here, we have a real nice clean signal. So each of those is basically a measurement of the pressure change in my finger due to my heart rate. So we can calculate heart rate through that, and we'll calculate heart rate over the average, so what it is for the entire minute, as well as instantaneous heart rate for a shorter sampling period, say 10 seconds or so.